I'm Renee Birchall and I'm a geoscientist working on carbon sequestration in rocks. I'm working on something called mineral carbonation, which is a naturally occurring process in nature that sequesters CO2 by reacting with the minerals in the rocks. This is one of the ways that the Earth's been managing its climate through the natural rock weathering cycle, and this has been happening for millions of years. One of the ways mineral carbonation works in nature is rainwater reacts with the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, effectively sucking it out of the air and creating carbonic acid. The rainwater then falls to Earth and weathers rocks, forming bicarbonate and then stable carbonate. The carbonate is permanently and safely stored. It stays in the soil, then washes into the waterways and eventually the ocean. We're looking at speeding up those natural cycles and engineering the specific mineral reactions so we can scale up and increase the amount of carbon dioxide sequestered. By engineering mineral carbonation, we can imitate this process using crushed rocks from industrial waste, including toxic mine tailings that can't just be released into the environment. Many of these industrial wastes and mine tailings already contain the necessary elements we need to react with carbon dioxide to create stable carbonates and even carbonate products like cement. Precipitation of carbonates through adding crushed rock to soils will improve the soil health, raising the pH, and also improve farm productivity. Engineered mineral carbonation can also be used as a stepping stone to assist fossil fuel-based industries in their pathway to net zero and in their emissions reduction strategies. Of course, there'll be concerns, especially about the potential environmental impacts of these new technologies. In responding to these challenges, communication is key. Having conversations with communities early, getting the right people in the room, and achieving social acceptance from the beginning will help us move forward together. That means having policymakers, First Nations representatives, and the scientists having those difficult conversations early in the piece. We also need to make sure that our negative emissions technologies are responsive to decarbonisation strategies so that the two can go hand in hand.